Good morning, my darlings. We're gonna have to do the vlog intro in this mirror because the other one has the sunlight streaming straight onto it and it is very dirty. So, good morning. Today is a very beautiful autumn day and we have lots of bits and bobs on our to-do list. So it's gonna be one of those days where we are doing lots of house things, quite a lot of garden things, so it should be a nice day to bring you along. Starting off quickly, just about to head to the garden center. I was in London yesterday and we had quite a lot of like bushes and trees delivered. So we're going with the main mission of getting some compost, but secondary mission is to get some autumnal kind of Halloween-y flowers and bits and bobs because I would love to do out the main door out here. This is our kind of front door. I would love to do in this area here an autumn porchway. I was actually watching one of Zoella's vlogs. She did a pumpkin picking and autumn porch decor vlog and her porch looked beautiful, not like crazy OTT Halloween-y, but I thought it looked very tasteful and I am inspired to do one here as well. We have got some friends coming over on Sunday, then I've got two girlfriends coming over the next weekend, and then we've got friends coming over the weekend after, so it'd be nice to have a beautiful porch and also for all our delivery chaps, and we've still got quite a lot of builders. So yeah, I think it is worthy of decorating. So I think we're gonna go to Wyatt's, are we?
Yeah.
Yep. And then possibly Dalesford as well, because it's only 5 minutes further. And
I don't think...
Yes.
Dalesford's not 5 minutes further, it's about 15 minutes further.
Still, I would like to
okay,
go.
All right.
So that's where we're heading this morning.
Get me a storage jar. That's the agreement.
Charlie said if we go to Dalesford, I have to get him a storage jar. It's a price I'm willing to pay to look around all the lovely bits and bobs. It is a glorious morning, Fashion Mumblr autumn weather report. I'm going to show you the trees outside because they are falling but also turning golden. Very quick outfit of the morning. I am of course wearing my barber. I think it is getting more use now, possibly, than it has ever had in its 30-year lifespan. Really gorgeous, cozy cable knit jumper.
Nice boots.
No, I haven't. Where's the suede spray?
I don't have any
time. Oh well, it is waterproof and they are protected already. I think they'll be okay. So these are my gorgeous emu boots. They are so soft. They've got like a shearling lining and it is so, so gorgeously comfortable. And my usual bag. Got my nails done yesterday in London. We also had a few pretty big home deliveries yesterday, so I will update you on those later on. A few of you asked where the pink armchair had ended up that was in the family room. As you can see, it is here for now. I think we were just... I mean, I do like having an armchair here.
I love this armchair.
Yeah.
It doesn't work anywhere in the house at the moment, does it?
Sadly, this house just doesn't suit pinky things, apart from in the pink room, as much as our old house did.
I think this would look good in the pink bedroom if it was a bit smaller.
Yes, it would.
But it's quite chunky, and the problem with it as well is how angled it is.
Yeah.
If it was a bit straighter back, because I think we need a similar armchair here, but
yeah,
slightly smaller and a straighter back so it can go nearer the...
Yes. Well, I think having it here has made us realise we do want an armchair here, but... Yeah, we'll find the right thing. No rush.
This room, this is probably the room, aside from the dining room, that is on least aware of what we can put in here. But
yeah.
I need inspiration.
We need a really nice big antique rug. We need a sideboard. Anyway.
Do we have a table here? Like,
possibly. If we find the right one.
We have a stove in here.
If we found a stunning antique round table, I think that would look gorgeous.
But then I don't think you'd want the side table.
No.
Right, that's it.
And the ammo.
Thank you.
I've actually just had a message from our neighbour farmer who said that I can get some hay bales from him, which is amazing news. So what I'd then like to do is create a little setup kind of similar to this. I want to get some of these crates and put some produce up on them. I'll be able to get some twigs and plants and conkers and things from the garden. But yeah, getting lots of inspo. Gonna have a look in the garden shop now and see if they've got a nice autumnal wreath or something like that. Charlie's taking pictures of the plant pots to get our, see if Ian, our builder, can whip something up similar.
Just constantly feel inspired.
I know.
When we're here in a farmhouse, it's such inspiring places, aren't they?
Yep. Boom. Expensive, but inspiring.
That looks nice. That's the sort of tree that I'd like to get on the driveway.
Okay, so we've now come to the proper garden centre and we are getting some compost for the trees and bushes we've got to plant later. Apparently we need one which sounds rather gross, fish, blood and bone.
Oh no, that's just the feed.
Oh.
We just want a multi-purpose compost.
Mm-hmm.
And then we want that feed that goes inside,
hopefully. Right. Okay, we're back home again. The dogs are going a little bit mad. Do you know what's really interesting from this angle, darling? You can really see that like half moon.
Yeah, well, because we've had the patio clear, didn't we?
Yeah, it looks as though there used to be a cellar down there, but didn't we decide it was from the well?
I don't know. I really don't know.
Looks like this. Maybe we've got a hidden cellar.
That's the building breather, I guess. But
yeah.
So the plan is, these are a bit taller. Basically, these are going to go in here.
Yeah. That's great.
So we've got probably three or four in there, and then one in here, and I was thinking about maybe trying to turn the back and sticking that one in there.
Yeah.
So we've got all of those in there, and then really we need to dig a bit more so that the laurel's a bit more in front out here,
mm.
And then we're going to put a load of laurel in here.
Fantastic. If you want to drive round, I'll just let the dogs out so they're not panicking. Home again, and we have put our Daylesford hydrangeas here in the fireplace with my lovely arena flowers. I haven't arranged these yet. I need to sort these out this afternoon when I've got a moment. I've got a little bit of work I need to catch up on first. We are going to leave these again to dry. I think the colours of these will dry so beautifully. These are just the perfect autumn colours. I think they'll look absolutely gorgeous. And then these are actually also with the intention of drying them. I think they'll be nice twiglets for table decorations and things like that. So I'm going to go out for a dog walk later with my secateurs and see if I can pick up some more bits. So you may have noticed when I was stood a little bit further back that we have a very exciting new piece of furniture. So this is... What kind of wood is this, would you say, Char?
Sorry?
What kind of wood is this? Oak.
Oak.
Yeah, I thought so.
Pure white lines, it's called.
Pure white lines?
Mm,
is at the antique shop on Instagram.
Weird name, but based in London.
Ah, okay. So Charlie found this in an antique shop called Pure White Lines, beautiful big oak dresser. And as you can see, it fits this space absolutely perfectly. Obviously, the unit we had before from Clapham that we brought with us was very much a temporary measure. And Charlie saw this, he first actually saw this on Instagram. So very, very happy to finally have the perfect bit of furniture for here. It's got loads and loads of storage inside. It's an old Victorian unit. It's got lots of marks on it, lots of bumps and scratches, which I just love. Huge drawer here. At the moment, just two very solitary remotes. And then we have got these big side cupboards. Charlie's got his fire lighting gear. These all pull out like trays, so it's really practical. And then little hidden drawers at the top here, which I think we'll use for, well, goodness knows what. We're going to put our board games in here so that when we have friends over, we can just play board games. Down in the family room, we've got Dex and Monopoly, as well as traditional Monopoly, Boulder Dash, all of our favourite games, which we love to play when we have friends over. And then, oh, I did that the wrong way around. And then this side is identical. This is going to be my side, my man drawer. If you've watched that Michael McIntyre sketch, just got my receipts for expensing in there at the moment. Charlie and I were debating about getting a Samsung frame TV because I do think that TVs are just a big black blodge on the wall, but Charlie makes a good point in that this TV is actually better quality picture than the frame. That's why we ended up getting this one, because the picture is absolute tip top. But we said maybe if Samsung release a frame TV in a couple of years which is as good as this picture wise or better, we would look into it. Also depending on the wires, because we've got friends that have got frames, and sometimes obviously it's up on the wall, so what do you do with the wires, because they're not wireless. So we shall see, but it looks fantastic. If I show you from this angle, you can see it really just fits in so nicely, especially color wise with the oak beam.
I started panicking then, but it's because the window cleaner's here. But there was water just dripping down. I was really confused, because he's obviously cracking on.
Oh, well done. Yeah, it looks fantastic with the George Smith armchairs, which, as always, you guys were right, they look much better pulled away from the wall. I think that's like a classic interior tip, to pull your furniture away from the wall, and it just makes the room feel, makes it feel like they're meant to be there. We need to hide obviously the laptop charger wires. Dickens is surveying from his favourite angle in the house. Why do you look so angry at me? What have I done to annoy you today? Oh, I forgot about me soup. So even though we did buy food from Dalesford, I realised I have this homemade soup which needs eating up that I made a couple of days ago. Carrot, turnip, it's basically a Thermomix soup. So I'm going to have that for my luncheon with some Dalesford bread.
Ooh. Instead of doing those, I'll come out and show you. Would you like a tea, mate? With milk, right?
Yeah, milk and
two sugars. No problem.
What if the world had more of your smile? What if the wind could spread your love?
Now, do we think my little boy is in need of a haircut? What do we think? My little boy, yes, I'm talking about you, Scruff Bomb, is getting very curly in his chessie. Oh, I'm sorry, am I boring you, young man? He's getting very scruffy in his ears. Let's have a look at the paws. No, Mummy, I don't want you to see my paws. Let me have a look at your paws. Oh, they're looking perfectly fluffy. Yes, I think little boys need a haircut. Oh! I'm sorry. Was I not giving enough attention to the original and the best doggy in the world, Mr. Handsome? Let's have a look at Dexy. Does Dexy need a haircut? Does Dexy need a haircut? Oh! I beg your pardon, Mr. Bossy Boots. Apparently, my hay bales have been delivered. Yes, there they are. Hashtag gifted by our lovely neighbour, Farmer Martin. And Farmer Matt. Woohoo! And this is my pumpkin, or should I say my gourd haul from Dalesford. I love these white ones, I think they look so cool. I think these smaller ones are going to be my indoor pumpkins for on the oh no, my stalk has broken! For on the dining table. I'm genuinely gonna glue that stalk back on. Right, I don't have half the plants and things that I need, but let's just go and have a look at my hay bales. So the plan is to create a little structure here. I'm gonna find some crates and some barrels and some bigger pumpkins to do a little display. I've got a little bit of work I need to do first, but after I've had my coffee, it's time to start my autumnal porch. Okay, I've just done a couple of hours of emails. There's still quite a lot to do, but I wanted to quickly show you in here. We're having our alarms tested today. We have this new candelabra, I think that's what you call it, from Soho Home. I think Charlie had a discount voucher that we used for this. I think it suits this room beautifully. Just a selection of gourds on the table, ready for my tablescape planning. And then the cabinet, which used to be in the family room, is now in here. Again, probably not permanent, but definitely a good place to start for storing all of our tableware, which at the moment is in desperate need of sorting and ironing. That is a rainy day task. Another tiny update. Over here we have got a shelf put in. These were some oak offcuts from other bits and bobs we did in the house, with these little supports, and Charlie has been oiling this wooden worktop, so it's all looking a little bit more neat and tidy here in the utility room. Well, it's typical that the sun goes behind lots of ominous looking clouds just as I'm about to come outside, but I'm now going to turn this porchway into the start of our autumnally decorated entrance. I don't have everything that I need just yet. Definitely need to visit a few more garden centres tomorrow, but I'm going to start with the bare bones, the straw bales or hay bales, and potter around and see what foliage I can find, and baskets and crates and things like that, and then we can figure out how much more we need to get tomorrow. I'm going to pop you on a tripod and let's get started. It's not a bad start, but obviously I need to get a lot more. I need to get a wooden crate. The white one just didn't look quite right, a little bit too modern and fresh. So I'm going to look for a wooden crate tomorrow. And then I really want to get some plants. I'll pop a picture of them on the screen here. Very autumnal, orangey inspired plants, and I definitely need a load more pumpkins, but I think the shape works really nicely with the hay bales, and you can see the look that I am going for. But yeah, just need to get a lot more of everything, basically. Wow, I think I've spent the past 40 minutes doing flower maintenance, but it's worth it. So I have, basically when these flowers arrived, I didn't have time to do anything with them, so I just shoved them in water, and to be honest, they looked really good, but they needed trimming, they needed arranging. So these are the beautiful subscription flowers from Arena, who I mentioned a couple of vlogs ago. They are the most ethical florist in the UK. They plant trees for every bouquet ordered. They don't use any single-use plastic, and to be honest, their flowers are just spectacular. This is this week's subscription order, so the beautiful roses, and they had the gorgeous eucalyptus in there as well. I obviously need to clean the fireplace, that's my next job. So I've just been arranging these. I'm not the best at flower arranging, but I do enjoy it, so they look absolutely beautiful. The hydrangeas that I bought from Dalesford earlier. And then these are, this is part one of the beautiful bouquet from Arena. I think I need to slightly rejig those. And this is the one I did first. So these last two that I've showed you are both from a beautiful bouquet from Arena Flowers as well. I don't know if there's any information in here about the bouquet. I think this is just information about, New Star Luxury Bouquets. I think that's what this was. But yeah, I've managed to make it into two. So I was watching a few YouTube videos while preparing those. I think these will probably just live in the middle of the kitchen island. But now I'm going to bring the vacuum cleaner out, do a little bit of vacuuming around cobwebs, up in these kinds of areas, around the dog beds, in the windowsills, etc. Clean the surfaces, and then probably just zip around the rest of the house with the Dyson. So while I have been doing all the inside jobs today, and I've almost finished cleaning the family room and the kitchen, Charlie has been busy doing the outside jobs. He has planted a row of laurel behind the Fotinia that we've got here at the side of the house, just mostly for privacy reasons, and we didn't feel like we needed a gate here. It just was something that we didn't feel that we needed. So how long has this taken you, darling?
Oh, well, this has probably taken about 4 hours in total for all the digging. Obviously, it's as much for the dog security, isn't it?
Yeah.
God, that look rough.
No.
So, yeah, I planted, I think, 8 Fotinia, red robin. And obviously it's very dusty because the guys are doing the patio today.
Yeah.
So it was not very good timing, but I'm going to give it all the water now.
Mm-hmm.
And then hope it all sort of settles in.
Yeah.
It's
look
the right
how
time of year to plant it all.
How burnt the fern is from the conifer bush is from the barbecue.
And you know what? That was like from the really early days we were here, because that was when we had the gas barbecue.
Yeah.
Because since then we've not... Well, alright, let's water it. If you want to see it from the other side, it looks a bit messy, but it won't do when it's...
How do we get round now?
I need another fritinia in this gap.
Well... It looks good, and we are having the patio re-grouted just to make it look a little bit neater. And a lot of the grouting was starting to crumble. So instead of ripping up the whole thing, which would have been very expensive indeed, we're getting it re-grouted. So it's looking a little bit bare at the moment. Goodness me, socks and sandals. But yeah, this is going to look like a whole new patio when this is done. They're doing a great job so far. And then we were thinking this plant pot that Charlie was looking at in Dalesford earlier, do you remember the wooden one? We would like to get one of those in the middle.
I think about here.
Oh my gosh, how cool would it be if we could get a massive Christmas tree here?
Yeah, I think really, I'm not sure about that. No one would see it.
Could invite the village round for carols.
No,
well, it looks good. Well done, darling. Busy bees. So both Charlie and I are too exhausted to cook anything for dinner, so we're eating our Dalesford salads, which we were going to save, but...
Do you know the positive of this?
Yes.
It means we get to go to Quince and Clover tomorrow.
Ah, and we're going to have a brunch at the farmhouse, aren't we?
No, I don't think so. If you want to, I'm just going to do some...
I do. I might just have some boiled eggs tomorrow at the farmhouse. So I have got a selection of different salads, and... Dalesford do coronation chicken really well. I had their little bun sandwiches last week, but this week they're doing wraps. And Charlie is going to have poached salmon and his deli salad box. I always joke about Dalesford being expensive, but look, this salad box, £12.54, and his salmon, £9. That's 20 quid. Could have eaten out for that price. But yes, we love it, and it is a treat. So I'm going to enjoy this. Charlie's cooking some boiled eggs as well. So I'm going to pop on The Crown. I'm trying to finish it before season 4 starts, which I think is November the 15th. I saw a teaser video the other day and it looks amazing. So yes, bon appetit. And we have started the day with a workout at the farmhouse, and then we went to Quince and Clover, which is kind of like a deli in Great Tew, which is the little village which Soho Farmhouse is in. If you ever visit the farmhouse, I would definitely recommend a little stroll into Great Tew. It's such a beautiful, very like typical Cotswoldy village. And Quince and Clover is a really nice place for brunch, especially if you want a little break from the farmhouse. Then we've driven to Chipping Norton, where Charlie's just had his haircut, and I strolled around some antique shops. Didn't find anything, just bought a couple more pumpkins. And now we've come to a garden center. We have picked up a few, and if you can see them, a few little plants for my Halloween display, and Charlie is currently filling up his basket with logs for the fire, because I think we're going to have lots of very cozy fires this weekend. So when we get home, I'm going to do a little bit more adding to my autumn porch. I definitely want to go and find another garden centre, because I still haven't got the particular plants that I really want, so hopefully I'll be able to find them somewhere, and a few more really gnarly looking gourds as well. So you may be wondering why I am in my dressing gown in the middle of the day. Well, I actually have booked the lovely Nicole to come back from the Ruby app. That massage a couple of weeks ago was so, so good, and I feel like this week I just need another one. Obviously, I had my facial in London earlier in the week, but with facials, they give you like a little teaser of a massage, a little bit on the neck and kind of chest, but I felt like I needed a full-on massage. So I've got 60 minutes with Nicole again. She is just absolutely incredible, and I'm so grateful that Ruby are now out here in Oxford/the Cotswolds. So I'm gonna go downstairs. We're in the drawing room today, a very opulent setting for the massage. I've just put a little bit of facial oil on, so that can be pampering me while I am massaged. So I will see you shortly. So we've decided to do the massage in the drawing room today, which I think is a very opulent setting, albeit surrounded by mismatched furniture and our old curtains, but it is a very luxurious setting for today. So I'm gonna switch off now for an hour and I will see you on the other side. Hello, my darlings. It is a couple of hours later. I have just been in a state of zen since my amazing massage with Nicole. She is so incredible. She literally just is the perfect mix between like a good massage that gets rid of the knots and a super duper relaxing massage. And I always need to drink loads of water afterwards. So I've just been on the sofa. I've started to watch Emily in Paris. I know everyone has their opinions on it. For me, it's just quite good, like, background TV. I couldn't sit and properly watch it. I don't think the storyline is quite good enough. But it's a little bit like, I don't know, a mild Gossip Girl. I like the glamour. I like the pretty scenes. But yeah, the storyline is not as tantalizing as Gossip Girl or anything like that. Anyway, now that I have regained my compass mentum and I can actually stand up and function, I'm gonna start preparing dinner. As you may have seen from a vlog a couple of vlogs ago, we have a lot of pumpkin to get through. So I'm gonna make my vegan mac and cheese recipe. Charlie has left out some cannelloni, so I guess I'm gonna do like a vegan mac and cheese pumpkin cannelloni. I don't know. I'm basically gonna use my vegan mac and cheese cheese sauce recipe in the Thermomix. It's a PDF, so I'll see if I can leave it somehow linked down below. I'm sure you can make it without a Thermomix as well. And I'm gonna just chuck a load of pumpkin in and pour it on top of cannelloni. It sounds pretty good to me. And I might actually blitz, because Charlie and I are not actually, ooh. Oh my gosh, in the light I thought I had really bad fake tan on my hands. I might blitz some parmesan and some nuts in the Thermomix as well to sprinkle on top, just to give it a little bit of extra crunch. So basically it is an experimental autumnal cheesy pastry dinner, which I'm very excited for. Okay, here we have the ingredients for the sauce. Here or there, I really don't have everything that I need, so I'm kind of making it up as I go along. So the main part of the sauce is actually cashew, but I only have this much cashew left, which is definitely not even a quarter of what I need. So I'm gonna whack in some peanuts as well and hope for the best. They look similar and I think they taste kind of similar, so we shall see. Savory yeast flakes, basically the vegan answer of cheese. Sorry, I've got Emily in Paris playing in the background. Corn flour, which I do have. Pumpkin, which I am whacking in. This is my last Tupperware full of pumpkin. I'll probably put half of that in. Some garlic, I'll put in a couple of bulbs. It does say to use almond milk. I don't have any almond milk, so I'm gonna use up this oat milk and tiger nut milk. Olive oil, a veggie stock cube, and what else do I need? Ooh, it does say lemon juice. Do we have any lemons that I can juice? Yes, we do. Fantastic. Wow, that is a big lemon. We have a very full drinks fridge for a couple who don't drink much. But to be fair, most of this is non-alcoholic. Very nice. So this is turning into a ginormous experiment. What you have just seen is me piping the cannelloni tubes with some roasted pumpkin, which I popped in this dish originally, the Le Creuset dish, in the aga with just some olive oil and salt and pepper. I roasted the pumpkin for about 20 minutes. Then I popped it in the Thermomix with a little bit of my cheese sauce, just to loosen it up a little bit. And what else? Oh, a little bit of non-vegan, like normal cheese. So that's what's inside my cannelloni tubes. Now I'm gonna build this up a bit like a lasagna with spinach, vegan white sauce, and this now fairly dry looking tomato. Let's see how this goes.